Atima Grace is the mother of 24-year-old Omonj Gilbert. He was only 3 months old when she discovered that her baby had sickle cells. And ever since then, her life has never been the same. After a prolonged illness in 2006 that kept Gilbert unconscious for 3 months, Grace was hit with the harsh reality that he would never ever walk again. The story, toil and daily struggle of Atima Grace and her sickle cell warrior represents the life that many families with children suffering from the disease go through every day across Uganda. At 21 years old, Lake Lilian, a resident of Laivi in Gulu City, has also experienced the difficult situation of looking after her sister who is suffering from sickle cells.
It is very challenging taking care of those kids, you know, when you don't have money, and their medicine is also expensive.
Present at JCRC is Dr. Okello Daniel. He is the Gulu City Health Officer and estimates that close to 20,000 children are born with sickle cells every year in Uganda.
Actually, majority of people have it, but they appear just like any other normal person. And we'll start with probably prevention. So you asked about how should they live longer. But what about how to prevent people from being born with sickle cell disease?
In his counseling session, Dr. Okello Daniel encourages a rich diet, warm and clean clothing, and monthly medical checkups as requirements in the care of a sickle cell patient. But fathers are also encouraged to support their wives, who are now known to carry the lifelong physical and emotional burden of nursing sickle cell warriors.
In most cases, when there is sickle cell in the family, the men tend to blame. They try to look for someone to blame. And in most cases, women have been blamed. The men don't want to associate with sickle cell. But it is my prayer to the men that nobody chooses to give birth to a child that has sickle cells.
However, sometimes the burden of sickle cell disease does not only affect mothers. Atima Thomas was traumatized during his time as an officer at the Uganda Police Force that he requested for an early retirement in order to support his wife to look after their son, Omonj Gilbert.
Mostly it is because of his problem. That's why I had also to leave the force, because now you find I cannot even concentrate given the condition how we were actually living in the barracks.
This is the case as Boniface Odu traveled over 200 kilometers from Lira District to the JCRC office in Gulu City. As more fathers take up the burden of caring for their sickle cells affected children, it is estimated that close to 15% of Ugandans have sickle cell traits. Dr. Daniel Muyanja is the Director of Clinical Services at the Joint Clinical Research Center. He is cautioning young couples against entering into a marriage or having children before testing for sickle cells.
Sickle cell disease is one of those illnesses, unfortunately, that needs chronic lifelong care. And I think it is an expensive disease even for an individual. Actually, in Africa, we are the fourth leading nation.
The Joint Clinical Research Center today conducted a sickle cell health camp in Gulu City in order to launch the provision of the sickle cell services in their Gulu Center and also to commemorate 30 years of their existence. I am Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu City.